Many on the North Shore were against it, but the state went ahead with it anyway. Today, state transportation crews installed cement barriers at Laniakea Beach, blocking off parking. As Brianne Randall explains, beachgoers are already finding ways around it.
Normally, it's high surf that causes traffic to back up along Kamehameha Highway on Oahu's North Shore. Not today. Instead, state crews with the Department of Transportation were causing major delays for drivers as they installed these cement barriers to block off parking at Laniakea Beach.
Over and over again, it was very clear the community didn't want this, so I'm amazed that it's actually happened. Yeah.
Earlier this year, the North Shore Neighborhood Board and a Laniakea task force both voted against installing barriers.
Even the Chamber of Commerce reversed its support. So there's nobody officially supporting this at this point, except the Department of Transportation.
To maneuver their heavy equipment, the state narrowed the busy two-lane highway down to one lane. It took our news crew a half hour to go 1 mile in the traffic. Residents were frustrated the DOT gave no warning this road work was happening 2 days before Christmas.
They should have thought it over, talked it over, planned it out, got together with the residents and the people that use the park and come up with a win-win solution. This is a lose-lose.
The barriers didn't stop Reggie from surfing at Laniakea. He just parked farther down the road and walked in. So did the Hyatrides family visiting from Long Island, New York. Their hotel recommended they stop by to check out the turtles, so they did.
They just said, park on the side of the road. You'll see a bunch of cars. Park on the side of the road and just come on down. Parked on the other side and walked over. You know, there's some construction, so the traffic is slow. So it was okay to cross it. We felt safe.
North Shore residents have complained for years about what has become known as turtle traffic. The DOT's reason for installing the barriers is to reduce the number of pedestrians crossing Kamehameha Highway to get to the beach.
I don't think it's going to work. I think the pedestrians will still be crossing the road, and that's the main reason. The main reason there's traffic here is because pedestrians do cross the road. Even today with 10 police officers and barriers, I've seen tons of people crossing the road.
The DOT says the barriers are only a short-term solution. They'll be in place for a month, and the state will monitor traffic flow to decide whether to keep them up longer.
1 month, in my opinion, would be too long. 1 year would be completely unacceptable. This completely changes the complexion of the North Shore. There's no other places with barriers like this around the North Shore. This is not the kind of way we like to keep the country here.
Now, North Shore residents want to see a road realignment project done instead, but that could take 5 years. In the meantime, a group of surfers opposing the barriers plan to file a lawsuit against the Department of Transportation tomorrow.